What was that, Dan? Sega, Sony, and Nintendo weren't the only one to join the mini craze? Well, yeah, that is correct. The world's best-selling home computer, Reborn. The C64 Mini. Now, they can't say Commodore. That's a licensing problem there. But they did get the size, shape, and a whole bunch of the games. Yes, and not only that, you can put your own games on here as well. Which, that is absolutely fantastic. You can plug a keyboard into this thing. You can code up your own games. None of the other minis could do that. You couldn't do that. At least not out of the box. You had to modify them in order to like actually put your own games on. But this, you can code your own software into it. You could actually use it as a computer. What? Yep. Bloody brilliant. Fantastic. Anyway, let's have a look inside of the box. The C64 Mini. Inside of the box was another box. And inside of that box was love. Alrighty, so say hello to my little friends. The C64 Mini. Now, what's really, really cool is I actually do have a Commodore 64 Mini-type plug-and-play system that isn't this, and it comes in a joystick very much like this. It comes with a whole bunch of Commodore games on it, and it's really, really good. So I will be comparing this to that slightly, just because, well, I've never had a Commodore 64 before. I was more of a ZX Spectrum kid, and even then, it was my dad's. I didn't know how to code it. I just asked him how to run the games, and then pressed enter and played. that was my experience of a ZX Spectrum. I mean, I was like 5 at the time. There was no way I was ever going to learn how to do that. But yeah, pretty cool beans. I do like this. The buttons feel solid. Very, very, very solid. I do like that. I like that they've actually made it like a proper C64. Well, I say proper. I can only assume the plug-and-play was like the proper one, because that thing's expensive and pretty harder to get a hold of these days. But yeah, pretty darn cool. Let's have a look at this. Now, from what I've only ever seen videos of the Commodore 64, usually on the 8-bit guy or, you know, channels similar to that where they're fixing them up and miniaturizing them and all that sort of stuff. So, yeah, it looks a lot like a Commodore 64. It's a shame the buttons don't do anything. How cool would it have been if they implemented the world's tiniest like keyboard? That would have been really cool. Stupid, pointless, but it would have been hilarious if they did. I think that would have been brilliant. It would have cost too much, surely, but I just like the idea of it if they actually made these buttons pressable, but I do like that. I like that it's got a power LED, super helpful. Nothing much to say on the side. There are two USB ports here. I believe that's maybe a menu button. Let's assume that's a menu button. On the back, we've got the power input, and we also have the HDMI. Might actually be the power button. I don't really see a power button anywhere. So that's an idea. It's pretty darn cool. Came out in 2018 by the looks of it, by Retro Games. Pretty cool beans. Now, literally, I've never ran a Commodore 64 before, so this might be a little bit cringe for people watching at home that grew up with this sort of thing, or at least know how to use one. But I am a complete outsider. Commodore 64 was not my forte. It wasn't something I grew up with, but it is something I'm super interested in because I love tech, and especially tech like this, your own personal home computer. So I'm going to get it plugged in, and we're going to have a little look and see what we can do. Alright, so here we are inside of the C64 Mini. And the first thing we get to see is Alleycat. Fantastic. Winter Games. Do I have that? Yeah, I've got that for the ZX Spectrum, I think. It's pretty cool. It's interesting to see what kind of games, like, came to the C64. There's a lot of games here I don't know, which is pretty interesting. Yeah, no idea. See, you can tell I just never grew up with this because I just don't know these games. Ah, basic. See, if you can plug in a keyboard, that's it. You can code your own games, put in anything you want. That's beautiful. Battle Valley. Boulder Dash? Oh, I know Boulder Dash. That's pretty cool. Oh, no. California Games. I've got that on ZX Spectrum. Pretty cool. Chips Challenge. Creatures. Seven and One. It's pretty. A whole bunch of different ones. Fire Lord, Hawkeye. So I have no idea. No idea. I haven't heard of any of these. But I have heard of you. There's a lot of good-looking games on here. I like that they use... I just love this about all these, because they are literally a collection. It's like a little museum piece, a tiny little museum piece. And they give you the year it, you know, it came out, who made it, the genre it's into, and a nice little description of it. They use the, the original art for the cover work as the icon for it as well, which is pretty good. I like that. It's really good. Let's keep going. Speedball. I know Speedball. C64 Hall of Fame. Yeah, there's all sorts here. Well, naturally, because it's the only one I really know, I think we have to, where are you? There you are, my beauty. I have to play this just so we can listen to it. Just so we can listen to it. I like that. Choose the following five items for your freedom kit before you start. Push left or right in the list and push down to select. Okay. Best thing about this? No loading time. This tune, though. This tune. Ugh. This is like one of the best video game tracks of all time. So much so even I know it. Of course I know it. I'm just sitting back and enjoying this track. I hope it's not copyrighted. I really hope it's not, because it's so good. Oh, so good. How do you play the game with the music? Ooh, you can. Alright, how do you play? Alright, there's a jump button. Good start. Screw it, let's go! Oh, that's no good. Can I do like a little jump? No! Really? Yeah, it seems I've got like a set jumping range, so I've got to be really careful. Let's wait for that to come down so we can jump. There we go. Right, go. Right, as soon as he's on his way back, we can jump. Go. I jumped over him. Ah, rude. Hey, that came down quick. Oh. So you can't jump over that? Then what's the point? Wait, what? I got beat up. But yes, best video game track. So how do we go back to the main menu? Oh, as soon as we fail. Very good. Alright, well let's just run over here then. Alright, so let's look at some other games on here. So we've got Boulder Dash? Yeah, I'll go for some Boulder Dash. I know about this game. I don't think I've ever played it. Have I? I can't remember. But it is a game I know about, and I kind of know how to play, he says. I don't know the rules, but I know that these boulders want to eat me. Ah! You don't get to eat me. No, I'm not edible. I don't know if the maps are randomly generated. They definitely look like they could be. Ooh. Wait, I can move boulders? Wait, experiment. Ah, so you can. Neat. Huh. Interesting. Oh, so they can move. Sometimes. What's the rules? We'll try that again. See, I don't know the rules of Boulder Dash. I only know that the boulders do move on their own. See, like that one didn't move. Just get out of my way, boulders. Yeah, it doesn't seem like it's randomly generated. But if I can just keep these boulders out of my way, should be all right. I go up. There you go. Grab that. Go, go, go. Up. Down. All right. What we'll do is we'll go down this one. There we go. Can't really move around, can you? Jerks. All right, we'll go up here, grab this. Slip under this one. There we go. What we'll do is then grab this one. Oh, there we go. That was close. Don't know what that flash was, but shazam. Right, I'll grab that one. Let that boulder do whatever the hell it wants to do. Woohoo! Woohoo! Mistakes were made. Alright, we'll just sneak under this one. Shazam. Go under this one. Go, 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 go. Go, go, go. Up, 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 up. There we go. And... aha! Success! A game I'm not awful at. Fantastic. Awesome. So yes, Boulder Dash. I like that one. Oh, why is everything moving? Horrifying. Yeah, no idea. Ooh, what's that? I imagine that's something that wants to kill me, right? Am I correct in thinking that? Let's find out. All right, let's go for Bounder. What is Bounder? Do, 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 do. Right, start. Yes, I want to start. I'm a bouncing tennis ball. Okay. Oh. What? Oh, you... Who put that stick there? No! You gotta bounce properly. Wait, what? Wait, what? What? Why is that bounce there if I'm not bouncing properly? I feel like I'm being bullied here. I do feel like I'm being bullied. That was a little bit... I understand I can't go through it, but I was under the impression that such an amazing big jump thing like that will allow me to jump, right? Right? Ooh. Hey, did that stick just come out of nowhere? That stick just came out of nowhere, didn't it? Hey, yeah, I stayed on there. Don't be like that. See? Oh, I got a bonus two balls. Just what I needed. Wait, jump. There we go. Those sticks are starting to piss me off. Hi to you too, game. Give me those bonus balls. It's old games like this that they really annoy me because of some absolute BS. They just fill it to the brim with BS like that. And that's the way they're designed. I just don't have patience for that kind of gameplay anymore. Say hello to Chips. This was apparently one of the really good games, wasn't it, if I remember rightly? Let's see if I'm any good at it. Right, I've got a key. Got a key for that door. Oh. Key for the blue door. Key for the yellow door. There you go. Perfect. Right, let's go down to there. Out. Seems relatively simple, right? He says. Got a blue key. Okay. It's the chip. Oh, I can literally grab the chips. Oh, I was avoiding them because, well, you know what I'm like. I avoid everything in these types of games because the world is full of crap. For the night is dark and full of terrors. All right, so I got to get that green key. There we go. I want one towards a yellow key. Oh, we've got a yellow key here. Perfect. Grab the chip. Grab the yellow key up here. Grab that chip. Go in there. Grab that chip. Go in there. Grab that chip. Shazam. The chips is out. Shazam. Yowza. First try. Yeah, well, that's because there was nothing to kill me. Right. Push blocks into water to make dirt. Watch out for monsters. Well, I already broke that. I already goosed that up. And that's okay. Because I can't pull. I can only push. So I've already goosed that up. Let's try that again, shall we? All right, it's a basic puzzle challenge. So what I need to do is I need to push that one down, that one across, that one down, that one across, and then that one across. Excuse you? Push blocks into water to make dirt. Watch out for monsters. But why can't I push that across the dirt? Excuse you, game? I feel like I'm missing a trick here. Why can't I? I'm completely missing a trick. Yeah, it just says push blocks into water to make dirt. Watch out for monsters. Got the chips. Because I can't push it across there like that. Oh, I've got to walk on it. See, that's what I was missing. Right, we've got the monsters. It seems they follow a path, and that's okay. Because that means I just have to... Oh, God. No, I'm okay, actually. I can completely avoid the path. Brilliant. Go. Grab the chip. There we go. Right, grab that chip. Okay. So, yeah, I learned something. You've got to walk on it. Didn't say you had to walk on it, but it makes sense. Talk to me now. Anyway, let's move on to another game. Because I don't want to spend too long in each game. Especially the ones I do enjoy. So yeah, chips, yeah. Apparently it is one of the good ones. Confusion. Explode every confusion bomb in an industrial plant across 64 factory levels. What's the worst that could happen? I got this. Easy. Alright, so I want to select level. Yeah, I will. Start player one. Right, in order to get that one, I know straight away... No, wait. No, I want to go to the bottom one down there. What are you doing? Wait, what do I have to do? Oh! It's that kind of puzzle. Okay. Alright, so I want to trap him over there. What happens if he goes into the void? Oh, that's okay then. Okay, it's one of them puzzles. Okay. That's okay. There we go. Figured it out. So yeah, it's one of them puzzles. Okay. I thought it was pretty simple where I had to just go from a point that I wanted to and you just follow the line. It was just a case of observation. This is a neat little puzzle game. Not my cup of tea, though. So I will jump out of that one. But I understand that one. That's neat. Cosmic Causeway. What's the worst that could happen? Yeah, just jumping through as many of these as I can. Just trying to understand them because, you know... Whoa, this is like pseudo-3D. Oh. Black is bad. Good to know. Oh, this is easy. Wait, what? What? Oh, I like the green. Wah. The end. Did I lose? Or did I win? First place, type a name. I think I typed IP. No. Whatever that is. Cyberdyne Warrior. That sounds more my cup of tea, surely. See, a lot of these games... I had so much patience for these as a kid. I wonder what happened. Maybe I just got old. Up is not jump! Oh, that was fire. Ugh. Yeah, I don't know how many games I have to tell this, but up is not jump. Ever. Apparently I can't sneak under that. Neat. Up is really not jump game. Who thought? Am I winning? I don't know if my bullets are reaching him. Did I win or did I die?
There's one of them. One of them. No, I died. Yeah, no. I can't stomach stuff like that. I'm too old now. I don't care. Up is not jump. Ever. Ever, 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 ever. Even in Super Mario Land on the Game Boy, up wasn't jump. Mega Apocalypse? You had me at Apocalypse. What do we get? So yeah, this is like a little peek into a universe where Dan didn't like any of the games, so thank God I wasn't around for these. Oh, apparently I can't take out balls. Wait, how do you fly this thing? Oh my God. Oh, it's fine non-stop. Is it an auto-fire? Oh, no, it's got it. Missile? Good for you. Game over. Yeah, no wonder it's game over. I didn't have a chance to dodge them. They were just... You just have to go around in circles and hope for the best? I'm gonna get beat up by a ball again, aren't I? Yeah, I got... Nah. I don't think we're gonna win with this bug and play. I will admit, it's. I just haven't got the patience for bullshit anymore. Like, as soon as I spawn on this, I'm getting shot to death. I know these games are meant to be difficult, but then there's a point where surely it's diminishing returns. No. What do I do in this? Interesting. What's the objective? I probably should have read the blurb at the beginning. But, I don't really... Is my objective to kill everybody? Let's assume. Oh, big brain. I love big brain. No? Oh, up is jumping this as well. Fantastic. Alright, let's keep going. No? Yeah, is my objective just to kill everything? Wait, I guess not. Okay. I don't know. I'll just reach the end of the causeway. Next game. Monty on the run, of course. Nebulous, Netherworld, I'll be pit stop. Rana. Skate crazy. Go for spin dizzy. I'm probably really offending everybody that grew up with this or absolutely adores this. I mean, I love it. I do love it. I just haven't got the patience for it anymore. Wait, what? What? Oh, is this like memorizing maps and stuff? Yeah, something like that. Right, let's go back. This is a relatively simple game. This is more my speed. Right, let's go back. All right, there we go. No, up there, up there, up there, up there. Get that. Yeah, there we go. That's how we win. Oh, can we not? You know what? No. Oh my God. Wait. Nope. Stop. This wouldn't be so bad if it wasn't isometric. I can't tilt the controller. That's not how they work, unfortunately. Yeah, because let's get to an open area, because I just want to see this. Right. Up. Down, this is
silly. This is so silly. See, and he bounces back. Oh, that's terrible. Don't do that. Oh my god, I actually launched back. All right, and then, oh, no. Then I just go down. Then I hit left. There you go. Oh, man, this is annoying to control. But the game's pretty simple. Next. I get it. Star Paws. I love Star Paws. Does he have lightsabers? Okay. Why have I got a chicken? Wait, why am I running this way now? Am I meant to jump on the rocks? Is this the game? Oh. I'm chasing after a chicken. Am I meant to... Oh, I'm chasing after a chicken, aren't I? Wait, so I am meant to jump... Am I meant to jump over those rocks? So I am meant to jump over those rocks. But how do you not fall? A little tap of the button, maybe? I like the tune. Tune's good. Oh, great. Now he's coming up behind me. Wait, now he's coming back the other way. Mickey Mantle, where are you? I tapped it. What? Right, so... Oh my god, this is so inconsistent. Why is there a tank? Am I supposed to catch the tank? Alright, there we go. Figured out how to not fall this time. Whoop! 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 Oh, I want to catch you now. Oh, no. My skirt will run the other way. We'll run to the other side of the planet. He won't expect us there. Oh, no. 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 Oh, man. I do like these games, but they're just short, really quick, annoying games. Oh, I have the green bike. Green bike? Green. There are rules. Let's go. Man. I need to put a whole bunch of arcade ports on here, though. The C64 had so many fantastic arcade ports. Even ones that were made recently, because the C64 has such a massive variety. Oh, how do you drive? Is that right? Do I just hold the button? Is that right? Oh, no, I pushed the stick upwards. Yes, I... There we go. We're learning. There we go. Nope. No, I just hold up. Okay. We're going to get to a corner and completely get crippled, aren't we? Yeah. You know? I knew it was coming, and I did absolutely nothing to stop it. Oh, I need to hold up? Really? Oh, that's irritating. Right, go, go, go. That is such an annoying beep. Right, now I can turn the corner. I'm not going to win this race. Oh, I control the gears? Oh, that's neat. That's a neat trick. Oh, I'm going to get wrecked by a cord. I tried turning that time. Epic failed. Pretty cool. I like it, though. I like that one. C64 Hall of Fame. Of course. Thing on a spring. That sounds irritating. I want it. Trailblazer.
fighting game. Iridium. Who dares wins. We'll go for who dares wins. Because I dare.
I dare. And I dare you to dare for me.
Aha, got a guy. Got another guy. Got another guy. Get back here. I dare. Now let's go.
Ooh.
Oh, God. Don't worry. I'm Rambo.
Ooh, I'll take that.
Ooh. I'll take that. He ran from cover. Chase him down.
Yes, I got him.
Oh god, they're everywhere. Ah!
Ha! Friendly fire.
Thank you. Oh damn. Oh, that's... let's go.
Ah!
Yeah, that's good stuff. I do like this. This is fun. Oh, man. Zynaps? It's a Zynap. Let's find out what a Zynap is. Zynap.
Daka Daka.
Oh, easy peasy. It's a Schmarf. I can fight Schmarfs. As long as they don't come up behind me or do anything stupid. There we go. Love Schmarfs. Schmarfs are my thing. Houston. I think. You can't take me out. I'm too good. Oh, snap. Oh, God. See, I don't know what I should collect and what I can't.
That's not too bad.
Oh, Jesus. Alright, doing alright, doing alright. Wait, what's the missiles? You lose those missiles right now. Hey, this is like a schmuck for babies. This is perfect. This is perfect for me. Oh, snap. Oh, I can't shoot the geometry? Ah! Damn it!
Oh!
So that's brilliant. But anyway, I think I've seen enough of this right now. I'll go off with some final thoughts. How does that sound?
Alrighty, so what are my final thoughts on the C64 Mini and its lovely controller? Hit or miss? Now, it's great in theory. Fantastic. I used a USB keyboard with it flawlessly. I could code away, have no issues, and it worked very, very nice. I was quite happy with that. The problem I had was getting it to run any software. I was using a combination of different USB 2 memory sticks, some from like 10 years ago, some from nearly 15 years ago. And just it wouldn't recognize anything. Even a 1 gigabyte USB memory stick I had laying around, I formatted them with MBR, made them all FAT32, put one file on there with the specific name, you know, V64 Drive 8. Text. I tried everything. Even tried updating the firmware. Could not get it to do that, and I don't know why. Now, I could run code. I could type code and play it from there. Unfortunately, I don't really have the patience to do that, and all I managed to do was get farts to show up on the screen constantly, which was amazing. It made me happy, but I kind of had to copy a YouTube tutorial because Dan doesn't know how to code. So, yeah. Farts on the screen. Fantastic. The controller itself feels nice. I do really like the controller. It feels really nice. I don't know whether it's faulty or not, though, because I've not played games from this era. I don't know what the reaction's supposed to be like, but there was a couple of problems with it. It seems to have ironed itself out, maybe, or maybe I just got used to it. I don't know, but I stopped having any issues. The buttons were working, the joystick was working, and I could cancel out. A lot of these buttons weren't really used with many of the games, and even if they were, I wouldn't know. Absolutely zero instructions on how to get them to work with this. This is for someone who kind of grew up with it or is interested in it. Kind of like me. I'm interested in it. I didn't grow up with it, but I'm definitely interested in it. It's a really, really cool piece of kit. I really do like it. There's probably something I'm doing wrong with in terms of getting my own homebrew and ROMs to run on it. There is a way to do it. You can do that, and if you upgrade the firmware in it, it's even more beautiful because you can literally plug in your controller, keyboard, you can plug everything into it, and it will all run very nice. Because they've supported this very well, and I'm really happy with what they've done. It's just at the moment, it seems that I've got a really early unit by the looks of it. Or I don't know. I just don't know. So hopefully I'll figure that out eventually. If I do, I'll hopefully make an addendum video where I will show a whole bunch of games playing. Because I had a whole bunch of games ready to go. I had a little fake Minecraft game to play I was going to show you. Tetris, Wasteland. Oh, God, I had so many good games to show you. Even Pac-Man. Can't go wrong with them. Unfortunately, that's not going to happen in this video. Hopefully it will come soon, though. Hopefully I can figure it out. I'm going to keep tinkering around with it because I really like this thing. The form factor, this thing alone is going to be one of my favorite things in my collection. It's so striking. A mini PlayStation? Meh, they made the PS1. A mini Mega Drive? Meh, they already made it. The mini, NES and SNES? Meh, there's been Famiclones for years. They've been shrunk down forever. This is like the first and only time we've ever got anything like this. This is special. This is special. The games, I like them for the most part, but they're all from an era of when they were short and shit. But they're enjoyable, and you will pile through. You just need to have practice. I'm impatient. And obviously, I don't want to spend an hour in a video playing one game, learning the ins and outs of it. I don't want to do that to you. That's very cruel. But some of those games I really liked, I got into. So I definitely want to know what you think. Did you grow up with this? And how much do you hate me right now for what I've said and how I was playing the games? Because I'm sorry. I can only apologize. I didn't grow up with it. And even if I did, I haven't touched anything like this since 24 years ago ish. Over 2 decades ago. Bear that in mind. I'm used to new modern games that hold your hand. These are brutal and beautiful. Also, there's a lot of people on Twitch playing these sort of games on there. So if you go into the retro section on twitch.tv, definitely go in there, check out all the streamers there. There's some really, really, really good streamers on there. One of my favorite ones is Coconut81. She streams Amiga games from this era, and they're flawless. They're fantastic, and I really enjoy watching her. But there's a lot of other really awesome streamers there as well, so definitely go check them out. Because, hey, it's always interesting, and we need to keep preserving these. And this is the best way. This is literally the best way of preserving the C64. It really is. All you have to do is just put one of these in, get a keyboard, you can code away. You are completely disconnected from the world. You can do it. Awesome, awesome, save. Save it to a USB stick. Boom. You've now got yourself a game made on a C64, and that will work on an official C64, which is that's amazing. That is truly amazing. It's a marvel of technology. It's fantastic, and I really, really want a ZX Spectrum version. Hit me up. I want one. Anyway, I've spoken for too long. I hope you liked this video, and I hope you learned something from it. And even though I was terrible, and all over the place, I hope you go out and get one of these, because it's well worth it if you're interested in the era or like the games. It's well worth it. Don't let my experience deter you from getting this. I wholeheartedly recommend it. It's fantastic. Even if you don't like the controller, use your own. Or use an actual proper keyboard that you like. Go for it. Dive in there. Get coding. That's all I can say about this. I just wish I had the patience for it. Anyway, stay safe, survivors. And let me know what you guys think. See you later.